Hello, I'm Waffles Are Better. In my last video, I talked about the data pack competition that I'm going to be having, and I thought that I should post another video going over all the final details since I've figured everything out. I now know how I'm going to be grading all the submissions and how I'm going to decide who the winner is. And also, MC Models, who has sponsored some of my videos, has agreed to collaborate with me on the data pack competition. They're going to start selling data packs on their site soon, and they're going to be contributing a prize for the competition that I will go into later in the video. There is a link to them in the description, and I highly suggest that you check them out. So the first thing that I want to go over is how to actually join the competition. What you'll need to do is join my Discord server. There's a link to that in the description. And you'll need to verify your username in this channel. So once you have your username verified, you have to follow the instructions and the rules for how to become a server member. And then all you'll have to do is go into the Get Roles channel. You'll need to type !! role events and press enter, and it will give you the events role. And that's also in the role list channel. And then once you've done that, you'll be able to see the event submissions channel. And once your data pack is done, you will send a link to your data pack uploaded to Google Drive right here. Now, about the actual competition itself. The rules for qualification are you do need to make a pack for the competition. You can't use a pack that you already have. It has to be a World Gen pack that actually works. It can't crash the game or cause errors or anything. It has to fit the theme of the competition, which this time is outer space, as I said in the last video. So you can't upload, like, a really cool pack that has nothing to do with outer space that will get you disqualified. And if you don't have any custom biomes, features, or structures, you won't be disqualified, but you're unlikely to win because then you can't get extra points from that. And so the way that I decide who wins, for every custom dimension, which there should only be one of, you will get 0 to 10 points for creativity and originality. So if you're copying someone else's idea, or if it isn't that cool of an idea, you'll get less points. And you can get 0 to 10 points for how good it looks overall. So like placement of the biomes and how the biomes fit together. And 0 to 10 points for good use of noise settings and dimension type. So then for each custom biome, you will get 0 to 5 points for creativity and originality, and that's the same as for the custom dimension. Basically, just any cool ideas that end up looking cool will get you 5 points. 0 to 10 points for how good it looks, so again, that's the same as for the custom dimension. Basically, just how well all the features and structures and stuff inside fit together, and the block choice and stuff like that. And then 0 to 10 points for how well it fits into the dimension. So how well it goes with neighboring biomes, and how well it fits to the theme, and all that kind of stuff. So for configured features, they will get 0 to 3 points for creativity and originality, 0 to 3 points for how they look, and 0 to 4 points for how well they fit into the biomes they are used in. So if you make a really cool configured feature, and then you use it for biomes that it doesn't even fit well in. So, for example, putting like an ice tree in a desert that doesn't go very well at all, you would get 0 points for that. If you make a custom feature for a specific biome, don't put them in biomes they don't fit in, obviously. So keep that in mind. And then lastly, each configured structure feature, so all your structures, they get 0 to 5 points for creativity and originality, just like all the other ones. They get 0 to 10 points for how good they look. Here's a 0 to 10 points for how well it fits into the biome it's used in. So again, that's the same as for the configured feature. And 0 to 5 points for each jigsaw extension it has and how well it is used. If you've got some good randomization with template pools and stuff, you're going to get 5 points for the jigsaws that you use for that. But if it's just to connect two structures and there's no randomization or anything, then you're not going to get extra points for jigsaws. So the total scores overall are up to 30 points for just the dimension itself, and then every biome can have up to 25 points each, every feature can have up to 10 points each, and every structure can have up to 25 points each, plus 5 per jigsaw extension each. However, you could also get a score of 0 overall with your dimension if you don't put any effort into it at all. So you could make 50 custom biomes that are all clones of each other, and you would get 0 points for every single one of them. Basically, quality over quantity. You don't want to make a bunch of stuff that you don't put any effort into at all, because that won't help you out at all here. So the last thing that I need to go into is prizes, and I did go into that before, but basically what I said before is that the winning pack will have a showcase on my channel, so I'll make a showcase about your pack, and I'll give you credit and talk about how cool the pack is, and maybe even do some survival gameplay if enough people want that. And you will also get a role in my server saying that you're a winner of a data pack competition. And then there is one new prize since my last video that MC Models has thoughtfully decided to contribute for this competition, because this competition is in collaboration with them. And that is a $50 gift card that you can use on their site. So going to their site, mcmodels.net, there will be a link in the description. You can see that they've got a bunch of really cool stuff, and $50 can get you a lot on here. The prices vary a lot. The main things that they have on their site are mythic mobs creatures and model engine creatures, as well as resource packs like this, and basically all other kinds of models, a bunch of other really cool stuff too. They've also got schematics for stuff, font textures, they've got sounds like voice packs. They're going to be selling data packs on here very soon as well, and I will be selling some of those if you guys want to check them out. Everything on MC Models is quality controlled, so that you know that anything you buy on here will be really good quality. And they've got support on their Discord server and stuff like that. They've also got a bunch of tutorials. I made a written tutorial on their site right here for my most recent data pack tutorial. You can see if you go to this link that it's got my data pack tutorial here and all this stuff that I wrote down. But not only for data packs, they've also got tutorials for how to use plugins and how to make resource packs. I'm going to be writing more tutorials on their site soon. And as you can see, there's a lot more stuff coming soon that's going to be really cool. So you'll get $50 to use on their site if you win this competition. But even if you don't get that gift card, I highly recommend that you check out their site, because there's just a lot on this site that could help with creating a really cool Minecraft server, and I just highly recommend that. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions about anything that I talked about in this video, you can let me know in the comments, or you can join my Discord server, which is linked in the description. If you want to join my competition, again, there is a link to my Discord server in the description, and you can start working on your data pack right now. And the competition will end in 1 month after this video is posted, so keep that in mind. You'll have to have your pack done by then. And depending on how everyone's doing on this competition, that date might change, because I've never done anything like this before, so if I do more of these competitions in the future, that will be more concrete. I really want to see what you guys can make, and I think it's going to be really cool. I reached 400 subscribers since the last video, and I really, really, really appreciate that, guys. I know I keep saying this, but it's just really true. I never thought I would get this far, and it's just amazing to me that so many people like the videos that I'm making. Thank you guys so much. Thanks for watching.